Hi friends, welcome you again. I am Dhruvo. Hope you have started liking this series. In our earlier videos, we discussed about new features of Java 8 and beyond and elaborately did hands-on coding with functional interface. You may want to check out those videos if you missed. In this video, we are going to explore predicate interface, which is one type of functional interface. There are multiple built-in functional interface provided by JDK 8 onwards, but we are going to explore predicate interface here. Now let's start with predicate interface Java doc. So if you click on the first link of this search result, you will see the Java documentation of predicate interface. These are the methods defined in predicate interface. Test method is the single abstract method defined in predicate interface, and these are the other remaining methods, three default methods and one static methods. You can also explore documentation of predicate interface from your IDE directly. Let's go back to IDE and let me show it. So this is my IDE. I am using STS. So I have already created demo predicate interface Java project, and I have also created demo predicate interface.java class. I'm using package name as com.examples.predicates. I have also imported java.util.function.predicateinterface. Now if I open declaration of the predicate interface from IDE by pressing command key in my Mac, also you can use control key in your Windows systems. So if you click on open declaration, the documentation of the predicate class will be opened. The assumption is your IDE is configured for the source code exploration. If it is not, let me quickly show you how to do that. So if you go to STS preference, and then if you expand Java, install JREs. Now here you can select your preferred JREs, whatever you are currently using, maybe Java 8, 10, whatever it is. And if it is Java 8, click on edit. And then add external jar, and from here you can easily, so you have to go to the Java home and then you will see source.zip. If you do not have it, you have to download it from internet and place it somewhere and select this zip, and if you click and open and finish, it will automatically configure the source with your JDK binaries. Now let me maximize this window. So here you can see there are multiple methods defined. First one is boolean test, which is single abstract method which should be there in the predicate interface, and this interface is marked with @ functional interface annotation. And also there are other couple of methods, in fact four methods. Out of that, three methods are default methods: and, negate and or, and the last one is the static method is equal. The only difference between static and default methods are static method cannot be overridden in subclasses. However, default methods can be implemented or overridden in the subclasses. Now if I click on the outline of this interface, we can see this is the test method that we will be exploring next, and also we will explore and, negate, or, is equal methods, and we will try to understand how these methods can be leveraged in our programming. Now we will write few examples using predicate interface and try to understand how we can leverage that. So let's start with our first example. So let me close these two windows. Now let's create one class, string filter predicate. I'm using public static void main also, just to demonstrate how to use predicate. Let me remove todo. So first let me tell you what we are going to do. Let's create a list of names or strings, I would say strings, let's say fruits. As a list method, we'll return a list using a series of strings. I think this should be sufficient. So our objective is to filter this list of strings or fruit names using some condition. Let's assume we want to find out which names or fruits is starting with capital letter B. Now to do that, we can easily use predicate interface. Let's assume, so let's define predicate interface. Here we can pass string pred. We can use lambda expression just to quickly implement the test method of predicate interface. Now from definition, we have observed that test method is returning a boolean value, right? So to do that, we have to return a boolean expression. So if we pass a predicate p, let's assume, so our predicate is a type of string predicate. So the parameter p is basically a string. So p dot starts with, if we write b, then it will return a boolean expression, either true or false, based on the input predicate, whether it is apple or banana. If it starts with b, it will return either false or true based on the condition. Now if we iterate through the list fruits, now if we check the condition using predicate pred.test and pass the name predicate, and based on the condition if we print a CISO or output value of the name, so our expected output should be the string or name of the fruit which starts with capital letter B. So let's run this program. See, you can see there is a banana. So if we change it to from B to, let's say, O, so it should give us orange. Here it is, right? So this is the first example of using predicate interface. So we are not implementing any anonymous class or directly implementing the predicate interface. Now in these examples, our objective is to use chain of different predicates. Like within predicates interface, we have observed that there are multiple default methods like AND, OR. So basically you can concatenate different predicates with AND, OR methods. So I have already written few lines of code just to accelerate the demonstration. So I am using the same list of fruits, and then I have also used starts with predicate. So our objective is to find out the fruit name which starts with B and also ends with, let's say, A. So let me write another predicate which ends with, I'm using lambda expression again just to implement the condition. P dot P is a string type, so we can use ends with, and then let's say A. Now if we iterate through the name of the fruits, so I'm using the conditional statement if starts with, so I'm using starts with predicate, then chaining other predicates using AND method and passing another predicate through its parameter, let's pass ends with, and return type will also be a predicate, so we can invoke test and pass the fruit. If this condition satisfied, then we can print the fruit name. Else we can say condition is not satisfied. So now let's run the program. See, the condition is only satisfied for banana. So for other fruits, it was not satisfied. So if we change it to, let's say, ends with E, let's see what happens. So all are failed, right? So no, there is no fruit which starts with B and ends with E. So in that way, you can concatenate different predicate and chain the list of predicates depending on your condition. In our third example, we'll explore OR method of predicate interface. So here I have already written the full code. I am reusing the fruit list, apple, banana, cucumber, orange, pineapple. And this time I am using two different predicates, starts with A and starts with B. So basically I am looking for whatever fruit name starts with either A or B. So if I iterate through the fruit list, then I'm using the condition starts with A or starts with B, then it should trigger the test method on input fruit. So if this condition satisfied, we should be able to see the results. Now here our expected output should be apple, banana, etc., right? So let's try to run this program. See, we see apple and banana. Now if you change it to, let's say, P, it should give apple and pineapple. Let's run it again, right? So OR condition is also satisfied. Now in our case, these are the very simple condition that we are trying to satisfy. However, in a real use case, maybe you will have a more complex condition, and you can invoke those complex logical condition using simple predicate APIs like OR, AND, etc., or even is equal. Now in our next example, we will be exploring negate method of predicate interface. Now I have created a negate filter predicate example 4.java class, and reusing the fruits list, I have used starts with A, where checking whether that fruit name starts with A or not. Now negate method basically returns a predicate that represents the logical negation of this predicate. Now basically it means, for this example, you are checking whether this fruit name starts with A or not. For apple, it should return true, right? If you apply the negate method on the starts with A predicate, it will negate the output of the starts with A predicate. If it was supposed to return true, now the negate call will convert it to false. So our expected output will not include apple, rather it will return banana, cucumber, orange and pineapple. So let's run the program. See, there is no apple. In our next example, we will be trying with external business object. So in this case, I have created a car business object under com.examples.bo package. And this car business object, I have two different properties. First one is string card type, and then the long price. We can quickly generate constructor and the getter setter from these properties. And let me also generate a toString. So our business object is ready. Now we have created another class predicate with business object example 5. Let me maximize this window. I have also written all the required code. So our objective is to find out cars which are either less expensive or more than certain price. I have created a list of cars using car constructor and adding it to cars list. Like first one, I have added Audi, which cost 100k, then Tesla, which cost 500k, and Mercedes, which cost 150k. So out of these, I am trying to find out cheapest car, which is less than 120k. I am using lambda expression to implement the logic. So C here, C is a business object. I am passing the business object through the lambda expression to the test method of the predicate. So basically it will take the get price of the input car object, and then will satisfy the condition whether the price is less than 120k or not. So we iterate through the cars list and trying to satisfy the predicate condition with the if block. So less than 120k dot test, we are passing car. So ideally our expectation is it should satisfy for Audi. So our output should be your choice of car is Audi. So let's run this program. See, your choice of car is car type Audi, price 100. Because we have implemented the toString method in this way, so we are getting this output. Similarly, if we uncomment this line and comment out the previous line, in this case we are using more than equal 150k predicate. So we are checking this condition, what are those cars which cost more than 150k. Now let me change this predicate name from less than 120k to more than equal 150k. So now it is compilation free, and now if we run this program, we'll see the two cars, right? Tesla and Mercedes, both cars are more than equal to 150k. So in this way, you can use this predicate interface in your object, different business object, or even for your arithmetical condition. And this will definitely help you to write concise, readable, and more cleaner code. And you can easily avoid writing more and more if and else block in your programming code. That's it, guys. If you like this video, please subscribe this channel and don't forget to hit the bell icon for upcoming videos. Thank you.